Hello, my name is Glenn Cummings, and this is the second in a series of demonstrations of writing code in Visual Basic. I call these prototypes because each of these will demonstrate just a few features of Visual Basic in as simple a form as possible. Our second example will use the same form we built in prototype 1, and the safest way to build a new project based on a previous project is to make a copy of the folder and give it a new name. Let me show you how this is done. This is Visual Studio 2012. If you have 2010, that's not a problem. It looks pretty much the same. And in order to begin from a previous project, we'll open Project, and this will open up you right up into the directory that contained the previous project. We right-click on that, Prototype 1, and we copy. Right-click below it and paste. This is a good time to rename that folder. It has nothing to do with renaming the project, unfortunately. Change that to Prototype 2, and we'll open it. Inside that folder is the solution file from the previous project, and we'll double-click on that. And that will bring us into our copy of Prototype 1. We have some renaming to do here. The prototype 1, I just clicked on it twice in a row, but not double clicking it, and that allows me to change it, edit it, change it to prototype 2. Same thing with the VB file. I can either click on it twice, or I can right click and rename and change that from prototype 1 to prototype 2. Looking at the code, we'll say view code. Again, there will be some text left over in the comments from before. We'll just change that from prototype 1 to prototype 2. And this first line where we just transferred the input text box, the text in it, to the output text box, we're going to change that with our new code. First thing we'll do is we'll add a new variable. I have that pre-typed here. I'll just drop that in. We've created a new variable called validInteger. It's a type integer. And I'll be using this to save the input from the user as an integer. The structure that we're looking at today is called the try-catch structure. And if I just type the word try and hit enter, it builds all of that structure for me. Here's the try, there's the catch part, and the end part. It's up to me to type in these two lines of code. Whenever the user is supplying you a number for input, it's up to you to check it to make sure that it's a valid number. Otherwise, it will break your program. So we put that inside of this try clause. This says if take the value from the input text box, and we'll do a parse on it. In other words, we're going to check it to make sure it's an integer. If it is, it'll be assigned to your new variable, valid integer. If it's not, it will return an error. And whatever is in this part of the structure, the catch part, will be displayed to the end user, and the program will return and it won't break. The simplest error message that it catches is the exception. This is any exception, any error that it catches, it will display this message that I'm about to type. This is a very simple error message. It just displays error and the message error message number that's automatically returned by Visual Basic. It's not very informative for the end user, but this is the minimum amount of code to test an input from a user and to prevent your program from breaking. If everything goes as planned, we can take that that input variable, which is now checked to make sure it was valid, and we can output it right here at the end of the program. Again, we're going to take something from the input box and we're going to put it out into the output text box. In this case, we're going to format it using the toString method, and there are several formats, but we'll choose currency. Currency will display a number with a dollar sign in front, a comma every three digits, a decimal point with two zeros after the decimal point. And that's the minimal amount of code required in order to check an integer. And let's try it out and see how it works. Click the start button. Type in any number here. Push the transfer button, and it is transferred from the top to the bottom. It's been checked to make sure it was a valid number, and if it is, it formats it with a dollar sign in front, a comma in between each three digits, and a period, two decimal places at the end. This number is no longer valid for input. You do not want to read a text field that has a formatted number in it, because the parse will not work with that. You need a number of the form that I showed, just a pure number, and let Visual Basic make a pretty copy of it.